Hello, my dear children. Today for class 9, simultaneous linear equation. In part 1, you have seen the solving by substitution method. Today for elimination method. There are two sums. If you follow attentively, then the method will be clear. Please see the board. The sum is given this. First, you have to write the equation in this way, 1, 2. From equation 1, we have to simplify the equation 1. By simplification of the equation 1, we are getting 13x minus y equal to 12. By simplifying what we are getting, you must give the name of that equation, that is part 3. And now from equation 2, that is from this equation also we have to simplify. By simplifying this, we are getting x minus y equal to 3. Give the name, that is part 4. And after getting the part 4, part 3 we have to write in this way. After writing the part 3, if you notice, then easily you will understand minus y and plus y. Minus minus, that is same. Then elimination, that means between two variables, one variable we have to eliminate by a multiplication or any other method, by into or divide. But here the same coefficient variable is coming by changing the sign, that is by subtraction. The variable y will be cancelled. This is why no need of any multiplication. Then when you are subtracting, then each term in this way you have to change the sign. After changing the sign, what sign we are getting, that we have to consider. So after that, we are getting minus 12x equal to minus 9. Then simplifying, we are getting x equal to 3 by 4. This x equal to 3 by 4, we have to put between these two, between any one of these two, that is substituting the value of x in 4, this equation. That is, value is coming 3 by 4. So in place of x, we are putting 3 by 4 minus y equal to 3. Then by simplifying, we are getting y equal to minus 9 by 4. Since it is improper fraction, this is why we have to convert it to mixed fraction. After conversion, we are getting this minus 2 and 1 by 4. Then we have to write the answer. Therefore, the required solution is x equal to 3 by 4 and y equal to minus 2, 1 by 4. Up to this sum. And another sum, that is this sum. In this case, same thing, we have to simplify the equation 1 by, from equation 1, we are getting by simplification, that is bx minus ay equal to 0. You have to give the name, that is part 3. And part 1, it is simplified form, so no need of simplifying more. So after getting the 3, then we have to write part 3 in this way. After writing, then it will not eliminate it usually by multiplication. Part 3 we have to multiply by A, and part 2 we have to multiply by B. By multiplication of this equation by A, we are getting ABX minus A square Y equal to 0. You have to select this in this way, that means X and Y. Between these two variables, one must be eliminated. In this way, you have to select these terms in which way you have to multiply. Then after multiplying, we are getting this, that is the same term, so you have to change the sign. After changing, it will be eliminated, and then by simplification, we are getting y into a square plus b square equal to b into a square plus b square. Then simplification, y equal to b, we are getting this value. We have to put between these two any equation. If I put equation 3, then it will be easier. This is why substituting the value of y in equation 3 we have. Y in place of y we have to put the value, that is b, the bx minus a into b equal to 0. By simplifying, it is coming x equal to a. Therefore, the required equation x equal to a and y equal to b. Sum is completed. In GIST, you have to remember, simultaneous equation, there are two variables. Between these two, any one you have to eliminate. By elimination, eliminate, that means you have to minus. After that, you have to follow this process. If you notice attentively, I think it will be clear. Please see the sum, see the solution again attentively. Okay, thank you everybody.